Hello, I'm Maruk Said, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
To begin, ensure you have the following: sterilization materials such as ethanol or spirit spray, autoclaved 1.5 milliliter Eppendorf tubes, autoclaved blue and yellow micropipet tips, a 1000 microliter and a 100 microliter micropipet, autoclaved distilled water, poured nutrient agar plates, a spirit lamp, a vortex machine, a glass spreader. Take out your autoclaved Eppendorf tubes and place them on an Eppendorf stand. You will need 6 tubes per sample. Label the first tube as the stock sample and the subsequent tubes as 10 to the power of negative 1, 10 to the power of negative 2, and so on, up to 10 to the power of negative 5. Here, we will work with 2 samples. Set your micropipet to 1,000 microliters and use a blue tip to add distilled water. Fill the stock Eppendorf tubes first. Next, add 900 microliters of distilled water to each of the dilution tubes labeled 10 to the power of negative 1 to 10 to the power of negative 5. Tip. You can use the same tip for this step if you avoid touching it to any surfaces. If you're using a soil sample, take a small amount and add it into the stock tube. If you're using a water sample, add 100 microliters from the sterile Falcon tube into the stock tube. Ensure your gloves and work area remain sterile throughout this process. Homogenize the stock sample using the vortex machine. For food microbiology, stock samples can also be prepared from food or meat. which can then be plated on selective media to isolate desired microbial flora. After vortexing the stock sample, pipette out 100 microliters from the stock tube and transfer it into the first dilution tube, labeled 10 to the power of negative 1. Mix the tube thoroughly by vortexing. From the 10 to the power of negative 1 tube, transfer 100 microliters into the 10 to the power of negative 2 tube. Repeat this process up to the last dilution tube, ensuring proper mixing at each step. Repeat the entire dilution process for your second sample. Once the dilutions are prepared, we will proceed with the spread plating. Sterilize your glass spreader by gently warming it on the spirit lamp, then spraying it with ethanol. Always turn off the spirit lamp before spraying ethanol. Vortex the dilution tube before micropipetting. Using a micropipet, transfer 20 microliters of the dilution onto the center of a nutrient agar plate. Use the sterilized glass spreader to evenly spread the dilution across the agar surface. Spread in a gentle circular motion, both clockwise and counterclockwise. Repeat this step for the other dilutions, sterilizing the spreader after each use. In this demonstration, we will plate dilutions from 10 to the power of negative 3, 10 to the power of negative 4, and 10 to the power of negative 5. Incubate the plates at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 to 48 hours. Ensure the plates are placed upside down during incubation. For fungal flora, use Saburao dextrose agar and incubate at 27 degrees Celsius for 72 hours. After incubation, observe the bacterial colonies on the plates. Choose a dilution plate with countable colonies, typically between 30 and 300 colonies, and calculate CFU, which provides an estimate of the viable microbial load in a sample for understanding microbial growth patterns, contamination levels, and the effectiveness of sterilization techniques. Then examine the colonies for their morphology and select colonies of interest and streak them onto fresh nutrient agar plates to isolate pure microbial cultures for further analysis. Similarly, examine the fungal growth on Saburao dextrose agar. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you.